Hello everyone, it's Ashley. Welcome back to my channel. Today is my first project as a part of the Ink Road Stamps design team, and I'm very excited to be on the team. I'm going to be using one of their new release sets, and this set is bananas. I'm going to use the fun little pun here, if you were a fruit, you'd be a pineapple, and I'm going to use the pineapple image. There's so many fun fruit puns in this set, and it's just a lot of fun and can be used across the board for everyone. I'm going to be making a birthday card today for my husband, and when I showed him the new release stamps, he thought that this was just hysterical, so I knew that I wanted to use it for him. This is a piece of 110-pound white cardstock, and it is cut to 4 by 5 1/4, and that is just slightly smaller than an A2 size card base. And I will be using Catherine Pooler inks throughout, and I'm using Shea Butter here. And I'm going to ink up the entire pineapple image and make a patterned background on this card front. So I'm going to stamp it in all different types of orientations, upside down and sideways. And this is just to make it appear as if this card front is a piece of a patterned cardstock or patterned paper. So when creating that type of illusion, as if this was a piece of a pattern paper, you definitely want to make sure that you stamp some of the images coming off of the cardstock, and this way it'll look like, I said, just a piece of a larger piece of pattern for the card front. So I'm going to be using Sauna and Grass Skirt for this dual tone or two-tone stamped image for the pineapple, and I am going to be using masking, but I wanted to show you that originally I had planned on stamping it with this block and then realized that my Misti would make this much easier, or any stamp positioning tool, but I grabbed my Misti, my mini Misti, and I am now just setting that up, and I'm using just a piece of scrap white cardstock, and I'm going to use the full sticky post-it note, meaning that the entire back of the post-it note is sticky. And I'm going to just mask off or place it right over the top portion of the pineapple, like the grass portion. And then using Sauna, I'm going to ink up the bottom half of the pineapple. And before I stamp it, it's very important to make sure that you take off that masking or else that ink will transfer. So I'm going to stamp this onto the cardstock. And this is only obviously going to stamp the portion that I inked up, which is just the bottom portion of the pineapple. So when I take it off, you'll see it actually kind of looks like one of those Fabergé eggs. So I'm definitely going to keep that in mind for maybe some Easter cards. But the other way that you can do some masking is with just some blue painter's tape or masking tape, whichever you use to sort of like hold dyes down or mask things off. But I just wanted to show you a different way that you could use, or different items you could use to mask. So I'm masking off the bottom portion of the pineapple, and I'm going to be using Grass Skirt for the top portion, the stem portion. And then I'll remove that tape again. And when I close this to stamp it, it's going to fit perfectly on top of the pineapple there. So it's going to be a dual tone stamp, even though it's only one stamp and you can't stamp it separately. You can use masking to do some creative stamping. And I think that's really cool and a fun little tip that can be useful in many different situations when creating and crafting cards. So I'm using some gigantic scissors to cut this out, and it's actually not so bad because these lines are really crisp and clean, but I had lost my scissors in the process of moving all of my craft stuff over to where I now have my desk, so I had to use some gigantic scissors, but it was fine, it worked out just fine. And I'm going to be using the If You Were a Fruit, You'd Be a Pineapple sentiment, as I stated before. So I'm going to use my Misti for this, and I'm going to sort of mock set this card up. And you can see that I keep turning the card front a little bit because I want to make sure that it's in the orientation that I prefer it. So I'm going to set the pineapple up where I think that I would like it, and then arrange the sentiment right underneath it, which is sort of the vision I had for this card. So once I get that all straight, I'm going to stamp it in VersaFine Onyx Black ink. And because this ink stays wet for a little bit longer, I'm going to emboss it with clear embossing powder to make it pop so that you can read it better off of the patterned cardstock or pattern background that I made. So I prepped the card front with a powder tool and I stamped it and put some clear embossing powder on it. And now I'm just hitting it with my heat tool. And you can see it just looks very bold and it makes it a lot easier to read on top of that background. I'm going to use foam tape all over. I just want to make sure that I get really good coverage. And another little tip that I like to use is to cut a piece of foam tape and then cut it right down the center. And that will allow you to get it in much tighter spaces, like the tips of the stems there on the top that you see. So I'm just going to go ahead and adhere this right over the sentiment. I'm going to center it as perfectly as I possibly can. And if you don't push down very hard when you're trying to arrange it, this foam tape is a bit forgiving and you can peel it off slightly, but just make sure that you're very gentle with it when you're trying to center it. So I'm going to create my base now, and I'm going to take a piece of 8.5 by 11 paper that I have cut at 5.5, and I'm going to score it at 4.25 to make an A2 size card base, or a side folding A2 sized card base. And to that, I'm going to add a black matted background for my card front. First, I'm actually going to put the card front onto the matted background or the black background. I'm going to use glue for this, and that is because it allows me some wiggle room. It's a very tight fit. It's just going to be a really thin border, so it's probable that I will not get it perfect the first time. So I like to use glue so that I can just move it around slightly to make sure that it's even on all four sides. And this black matted background is cut to 4 1/8 by 5 3/8, which is slightly bigger than the card front and slightly, very slightly smaller than an A2 size card base. So to adhere it to the card base, again, I'm using glue. And again, that's just to make sure that I have a little bit more wiggle room to get it perfectly center and have white on the outside, even throughout on all four sides. And I like to add black matted backgrounds, especially on cards for men. Like I said, this is for my husband, and I just think it adds a little bit of something. I wouldn't say this is technically a girly card or a masculine card, but for masculine cards, I like to add the matted black background. I'm going to use glossy accents on the colored spaces, those little diamond patterns on the bottom portion of the pineapple, and this is going to give some dimension and shine. And I know that the outside of a pineapple isn't very shiny, but I liked the look of it anyway. So here is the completed card. It was super easy and I really love how it came out. My husband loved it and he proudly displays it for everybody to see what a fine apple he is. Thank you so much for watching. As always, my blog, Pinterest, Instagram, and all of the supplies used are linked in the description. Thank you so much and I will see you very soon. Thanks. Bye.